welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is April, and for today's video, I just kind of wanted to talk to you guys about social media and my job as Miss New York and kind of like pageant jobs in general, so I can maybe clear up a few things that people have questioned or that people have received, like myself, some backlash on and all of those kinds of things, because I think that there's a lot of misconceptions and I think that social media has been getting a little bit of a bad rap. And I just want to kind of clear those things up and show you guys a different perspective of what it is that we do. But before I get into that, I want to show you guys the tea that I'm drinking. I'm having Yogi's green tea kombucha. It's a decaf version of the green tea, so it's not going to rile me up if I'm feeling a little bit anxious. And it's really good for your immune system and your digestive functions. It also doesn't have that typical kombucha taste. Kombucha can be a very acquired taste. I don't really know how to explain it. It can be a little bit like almost spicy because a lot of the times it's infused with ginger. This one does not have that. It does not taste bad at all. I actually really enjoy the flavor, and it's really healthy for you. So into the video. So let me just explain to you what it is that I do with my title. So let's just start there. So basically with my title as Miss New York, I will be going around for the year making appearances. Sometimes they're fun, glamorous things that you would typically expect. Like sometimes it's photo shoots and things like that, very girly types of things. But a lot of the times it is charity work. And I would say about 90% of it is charity work. Most of what you're doing is charity work. So we all obviously have our own platforms. You guys know my platform revolves around depression and anxiety. You guys know my platform is a mood cure. We talk about this all the time. And typically what we do is we all pick something that is close to our hearts. So for me, that is depression and anxiety. For someone else, it may be cancer. For someone else, it may be Alzheimer's. For someone else, it just, you know, it can be even more lighthearted, like something like child literacy, or, you know, it doesn't always need to be an illness. It can be different things, but it's just whatever kind of gets your heart going and something that is going to better the world around you, hence the whole world peace stereotype that we have, which I don't really think is that bad of a stereotype, to be honest with you. So a lot of the things that you'll see me do throughout the year are going to be charity-based, and a lot of the things that you also see me do are going to be very fun things. Like, I love, you know, you guys know that I love my YouTube stuff. I love doing photo shoots. I love playing with makeup. I love doing all of the girly things because at the end of the day, I'm still a girl and I have my girly interests. So if you guys don't know, this weekend, from Friday to Saturday, I actually slept outside on the street in New York City at right outside of a homeless shelter called the Covenant House in NYC. I will leave their website information, all of that, in case you guys want to check them out, find out what they're all about, donate to them, whatever it is you guys want to do, down in the description bar below. And I'm going to say about 99% of the people were so supportive that I was doing that, and actually 100% of the people at the shelter were so supportive of everyone who was doing it because of the amount of money that we were able to raise, and even the homeless children who were there, because we were there supporting the homeless youth, and they were so excited. They didn't even know that we were going to be there, and they were so excited that we were there, and they were like, I can't believe you guys are doing this. Are you guys crazy? It was like funny. It was just like funny to like watch that. You know, obviously we didn't go in there thinking that we're experiencing what it's like to be homeless. Like, no, not at all. You know, at the end of the day, I can sleep out there for a night, but I still know that the next day I get to go back home to my family. I'm going to be able to sleep in bed the next day. I don't have to question those things. And a big part of all that to me would be the anxiety and the fears and the unknown. All of those kinds of emotions is such a big part of homelessness. So obviously we don't think that what we were doing was experiencing what it's like to be homeless. And some people had thought that that was what I thought I was doing and thought that it was like foolish and that what I was doing was not enough or was not helpful. And I just want to kind of clear up why I was doing what I was doing, because a lot of people think you do these things just for publicity, you know? But I'm going to explain to you why we're doing what we do and how it actually works. As you guys know, social media is huge. It's, I mean, everybody for the most part, I would say, like, I don't even know what the percentages of people who use social media, but social media is huge. It is so important. It's so beneficial, especially. And I know it gets kind of like a bad rap because people always say, you know, people say to me all the time, like, you know, you put your best foot forward on social media. And I'm like, yep, I do. 100% I put my best foot forward. I wouldn't try to do anything else. I even try to do that in my real life, but unfortunately I don't all the time. I sometimes, you know, obviously we make mistakes and things like that, and same goes for social media, but I think it's not like a bad thing to put your best foot forward on social media. To me, it's almost like a digital resume. You're kind of showing the world what you are, what you want to portray, and I don't think there's anything wrong with that. You know, a lot of people are like, it's giving other people unrealistic expectations, or, you know, people are then comparing their lives to yours and they're not feeling as secure with themselves. And I don't think that that's the approach we should take to social media. I mean, of course, naturally we're going to compare ourselves, but we're going to compare ourselves in real life too, you know? Especially if someone who's my age has like all their stuff together, and I know plenty of people who are my age who have their like whole lives together and they're beautiful and they're intelligent. Like, I'm going to compare anyway, whether or not it's on social media. It's just like my human instinct. Not saying it's okay to do that, but it's going to happen on or off social media. So I think that's more of like a human flaw and not a social media flaw. And I don't really think that by doing any of the things that we do on social media that we're setting an unrealistic expectation. I think that if anything, I know that the girls that I look to inspire me to be better, because sometimes I'm like, damn, like this girl got up so early this morning. She like is taking care of herself. She's being really healthy. And maybe she's not healthy all day, but I love when people portray all of those good things and they feed me the good things, because it makes me want to be better. And to be honest with you, I wouldn't be who I am and doing what I do if it wasn't for social media. I mean, guys, you know that YouTube is literally my job. It's really not a bad thing. And to touch more on like the pageant side of it and bringing the pageants into social media, when people think that what we're doing is insincere, for example, I just want to like clarify that I think we all, whether you're a pet, sorry, monkey's about to start playing with the bracelet on the floor. I think whether you're a pageant girl or you're not, you have something that is close to you. You have a personal story. We all have our personal stories. We just, I guess, like to talk about it. It's just, for me, like I said, it's more of like a creative outlet. And when it comes to social awareness for causes that are close to our hearts, social media is so beneficial, because, for example, like what we did from Friday to Saturday, that entire event, we were able to raise $253,000. And that would not have happened without social media. It's much more difficult to get the word out there. You know, we're all so connected on social media, and that's the perfect way to do it. So when we put those things out there, we're putting it out there because it is so important. It is so beneficial. The money that can be raised, obviously the awareness that can be raised, and it's just all so effective. And I think a lot of people miss that little bit right there. And of course, you know, when I show up at these things with my sash on, it's because people, for some reason, I don't even know why, if you've got a sash and a sparkly crown on your head, people like just want to like talk to you and be like, well, what do you do? It's just a conversation sparker. So, you know, when you go to these things, you're able to get your voice heard, and it's a lot easier to get your voice heard, which I think is awesome. I mean, I wish everybody can get their voice heard all the time in those situations. Even myself, when I walk out of the house without my crown and sash, I want to get my voice heard even more. But, you know, this is so wonderful that I have an opportunity like this to be able to wear something like that, that is going to spark these conversations. And like I said, social media just really pushes that to a completely different level. And I truthfully wouldn't be able to do most of the things that I do without it. So basically, as Miss New York, my job is to represent the state of New York in many different sectors of life, both the glamorous, the unglamorous, and causes that really resonate with my heart from personal experiences, and causes that I may actually know nothing about. And it's honestly such a learning experience for me too. You know, we go in there, and I don't think any of us, well, I can tell you from my personal experience, I don't think I am like some life changer. I definitely don't think that, and I hope that people can understand that about me. I am not some overly confident woman who thinks that I'm like out there saving the world, although I will say there are some girls that I have been keeping up with for a few years, and the things that they do for their communities are like absolutely insane. I mean, especially the girls competing in the international level in some big competitions, the things that they do with their platforms are just like, it's so inspiring to me. And then I look at what I do and I'm like, damn, I pretty much do nothing compared to what these girls do, because they are so good. But that just goes back to the whole comparing thing that honestly inspires me to do better and to do more and be more effective. But to be completely upfront with you and what I think, you know, why somebody like me goes after a title like this, it's not, you know, I know we call it a beauty pageant. I almost like wish we could rename it to just be a pageant, which nowadays it's referred to just pretty much as a pageant, but people, you know, still call them beauty pageants. It's not about like who is pretty. That's not what beauty in the beauty pageant like phrase means. Basically, it's like what you're doing with your life. What are you doing that makes you beautiful? And when it comes to like the stage portion with like the gown and this, even the swimsuit, because a lot of people question swimsuit, they can seem like pretty superficial to some people. That's just all about taking care of yourself. Like, are you taking care of yourself? And it doesn't matter, you can be whatever frame that you are. Like, you don't need to be stick thin, you don't need to be super curvy, you kind of are what you are, but are you taking care of your body? They want to put somebody out there to represent either your region, your state, your country, the world, who is showing that they really care for themselves and that they're really taking care of themselves. I hope, I don't know if you guys hear that, but Monkey's playing. Are you sneezing? Bless you. Anyway, they want to put somebody out there who shows that they can take care of themselves, because the job can be very tiring. They want to make sure that you're on top of things. And you know, just like any other job interview that you would go to, they're going to pick the candidate that they feel is maybe the most well-rounded in that moment. So that's where the whole like beauty aspect comes in. I mean, interview is usually the biggest portion. You can win it in an interview and you can completely lose it in an interview, and that's because it matters what your personality is like. And truth be told, a lot of people, I don't think they understand, you can't win a title like this if you go in with no community service background. Sorry if you hear Monkey running around. Monkey, why are you so hyper? It doesn't matter how pretty you may be, you have to be able to show that you've been sort of fulfilling this job without the title already. So I just hope that that kind of cleared some of that up, just to kind of express that, because I feel like even the media doesn't express it the right way. And it's not the media's fault, it's just that you guys see... I'm sorry, she's just being really hyper. Can you stop running around for a minute? Can you run around a little later? It's just that the media is going to show you guys what you guys are able to see. Like, for example, the competition stage. You guys see what goes on stage, and that's pretty much, for the most part, it. Unless you're following girls throughout their reign, or even leading up to their reign, and with their personal lives, all those kinds of things. So you're not really going to know those things just from watching like a 3-hour pageant on TV, which is nobody's fault. And that's why we have social media. And that's why social media is so beneficial. Monkey, she almost knocked this huge like wood door thing down. That would have really been bad. She's like out of control today. But yeah, so I just wanted to say that, like, I hope people can get on board with this even more. I know everyone who's subscribed to my channel has been so supportive of this, but if you're coming from different like social networks, I want you to watch this, and I hope maybe I cleared some things up. I hope I didn't make things more confusing. But if you guys have any other questions about what I do and about the social media things and the sincerity behind what it is that we're doing and why we're doing it and how it's actually effective and it's truly working, then, you know, just leave a comment and I will be more than happy to sit there and answer a few things, because I've done that over the past few days and people have like really opened their eyes, and I love when people have open minds about it, because they're like, oh, I actually didn't know any of that. And it's like, I totally get it, because that's not what you see on TV. So, you know, I understand why people don't know it. So that's why I'm hoping that this may clarify some things. Monkey, you gotta calm down. And as for just social media in general, this is just a favor that I'm asking you guys. Be kind. I mean, I would say like 90% of the people are kind, but even when I'm looking at like celebrities' pages, like people that I like to follow Selena Gomez, and I like to follow a bunch of like big YouTubers, and you know, even like somebody like Kendall Jenner, guys, backlash that they get on every little thing that they do. They're not pawns in your world of entertainment. They are human beings with feelings. They have jobs. Whether or not you think their job is difficult or not, or that their job is worth the money that they're getting, it's not up for you to decide. I think it's our job as people to just be kind. So maybe instead of like going on to Kendall Jenner's page and, you know, bashing her for the way she looks, the way she dresses, or saying that she only got where she got because of, you know, her family or because of her sisters and whatever, like, just think twice about it. We all have gotten somewhere because of something, you know? We've all gotten somewhere. Either we've made a really awesome connection, networking, and that was able to get us a job, and that's the same thing that these people do, and I think that that's really awesome that they were able to utilize it and benefit their own lives. So just like be mindful of that when you're like commenting on people's things. I think they take so much heat for it, and I know after a while I'm sure they become numb to it, but they're still human beings and they still deserve kindness just like the rest of us do. So yeah, that's that. And then the last thing I just wanted to touch upon is why we do these things. So of course we have our platforms that we love, but in general this is such an amazing platform to be able to grow yourself for many reasons. And in this sense, I don't know, I can't speak for anybody else, but I become really super selfish in this sense. And It's just because it's the perfect opportunity for me. So basically, aside from being able to be heard with all of the things that matter to me emotionally, which in a sense can be also selfish, but with that said, it really opens a bunch of doors, and doors like that you wouldn't even imagine. I mean, anything that you want to go into, whether it's, it doesn't need to just be like entertainment or the beauty or fashion industry, and I think that that's a big misconception that a lot of people have, understandably, because it's a pageant, but you can make connections like crazy with anything that it is that you want to do. And with schools, you can get a ton of scholarship money, you can go to the school you want to go to, you can get the job that you want to get, like all of these things just kind of open up for you because people now have their eye on you. And so people just kind of flood in and they want to help you. And it's really cool because with something like this, you know, I'm able to grow my career as well. This is going to be an extreme life changer. You know, that's why you really only need the title for a year, because you don't need it your whole life, because you get these doors open for you immediately. I mean, I'm like a few weeks into this and my life has completely changed. And it's also a big factor when it comes to personal growth for somebody like myself, because I learn so much. I mean, you're around a whole bunch of different people and you're always trying to like listen to all the different people that you're around, and you learn things about different causes that you didn't know about, just different cultures, different things about the world you had no idea about. And you learn a bunch of social skills, you learn things about yourself that you never knew, because you're put in different situations that you were never put in before, things that you were never required to think about, you suddenly start thinking about more often. You just mature, and you mature very quickly. So I really think it's a huge benefit for that as well, and I don't think there's anything wrong with using your connections for your benefit, and I really would actually recommend it if you're somebody who's already got a title or you're interested in competing in pageants and you want a title. I think that that would be the perfect opportunity. I think whether or not you have this or you have something else that can kind of give you that voice, use it. Like, there's no reason to not use it. And let it better you in general with every aspect of your life, with your relationships, your friendships, your career, your inner peace, all of those things. Let it teach you. Just, it can teach you so much if you just open your eyes a little bit. So that was just kind of like the last thing that I want to touch upon with why I kind of get myself into it, because it is just so helpful. It's like a real backbone for a little while, and it gives you a real push in life, and I think it's really incredible. So now that I just went on that rant, I'm sorry that was very long. I hope I wasn't all too scatterbrained. I didn't really plan on what I was saying. I just kind of knew what I was thinking, and I just wanted to kind of go from there. So that's pretty much that. I hope you guys like this video. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button and turn on the bell notifications, because I put out new videos every single Sunday and Wednesday. If you guys didn't watch last Wednesday's video, go click right here. I did a review on the Luxury Scent Box. It's a perfume subscription for both men and women. It's actually really interesting. So I would go head on over there to go watch that. And I'm going to leave the links to quite a few different causes that I'm really passionate about and that I'll be speaking about this year. And if you guys have any causes that you want me to volunteer for or do any sort of appearances for, you just let me know in the comments below, because if I can be a voice for you while I have this, I would be more than happy to do that. And be sure to go check out the Covenant House page down in the description bar below, because that was really, really fascinating to me, what they are able to do for children and the way that they can help the children in every aspect of their life, especially with their mindset. It was really mind-blowing, to be honest with you. So yeah, I hope that clarified things, and like I said, feel free to leave any questions down below as well, and I will try to clear any other things up for you that you may have questions on. All right, bye guys.